Hello everyone. Today we are here with the part 2 of the lesson White Fan, which has been written by Jack London. We have already seen in the part 1 that this story is about a wife, White Fan, which is a young grey wolf who was born in the wild in Canada. His mother was a half wolf and a half dog. Before, he lived with Grey Beaver, and one day what happens that Grey Beaver, he goes to a fork Yukon to trade, and there he is tricked by Beauty Smith, who is a very cruel and brutish man, and that is why it resulted into parting with White Fang. Now, after Grey Beaver, White Fang lived with Beauty Smith. Beauty Smith used White Fang for his own purposes. In order to earn money, he involved him in fight with dogs as well as wolves for only earning money. One day, White Fang was just about to die during his fight when a man who was very kind, he rescued White Fang. And that man's name was Whedon Scott. Now he tamed him and takes care of White Fang, and he took him to his home, that is in Sierra Vista in the estate of California. There he is very treated lovingly, and he is just involved with the love and care given by his new family of his master. White Fang there learns to love his new master, and one day what happens that there was a secret shared between the white master of White Fang's wife, and the name of the wife was Alice. So there was a secret between Alice and White Fang, and the secret was that Alice, when she rose, she let him into sleep into the big hall. He was not allowed to sit into the hall. He was just sleeping outside the home. So she let him in to sleep in the big hall, and every morning she got up early and slipped down and let him out before the family was awake. So this was a secret between Alice and White Fang. Now, we know that dogs are very cunning and they can hear all the things very clearly. They have a very great hearing capacity as well as a smelling capacity. So White Fang, one day he was lying there, he was sleeping in the night, when he smelled the air and read the message that there was someone, a stranger. There was a stranger's presence, and he just came to knew. He smelled the presence of some stranger in the house. So he stopped moving, and he, without making any disturbance or loud noise, he just followed that stranger very quietly and very softly. Now White Fang has also lived in the wild during his beginning days of life. So there he knew how to hunt his prey. So this time also he was very, very careful that while stalking the stranger. So now when the man paused at the foot of the great staircase and listened that nobody is coming, White Fang was quietly watching everything, and he was waiting, and he did not give any chance for the man to save himself, and he did not make any warning, he did not give any warning to the man. And when the man lifted his foot on the stairs, suddenly White Fang struck on him and he attacked that person. There was a great fight between both of them. There were crashing sounds, and there was a struggle between both of them, and they were rising, charging in again and again, and this made everyone in the house to rise. Everyone came downstairs, and there were revolver shoots also during their fight, and because that there was a stranger and he was having a revolver in his hand, so there were snarling and growling and smashing and scratching of furniture, and a lot more sounds were there. So by hearing all these kinds of sounds, the noise made by White Fang as well as the stranger, and the sound of the furniture, the smashing of them, and the growling sound of White Fang, all due to by listening all these sounds, the people of the house came downstairs and they looked towards both of them. When the Whedon Scott and Judge Scott also. Judge Scott is the father of Whedon Scott. So when Whedon Scott bent over and turned towards the man face upward, he saw that that stranger was none other than a notorious criminal whose name was Jim Hall. And this Jim Hall, this person, this criminal was sent to the prison by Judge Scott only. So till here we had seen in the last part. Now coming to the next part of the story, White Fang after fight with the stranger. Now White Fang was also lying on the floor with his eyes closed with a little bit consciousness only, and the dog was feeling very very weak after his fight with Jim Hall, who was a notorious criminal. And suddenly what happened, his eyelids shut and his whole body flattened out upon the floor. So everyone, when they looked towards White Fang, he was looking very very weak and his eyelids were slightly just closing only, and he was making efforts to wag his tail in fact, but he was not able to do so. He was just bleeding, he was very very weak due to his fight, and he was making a weak growl. Now what happened, his eyelids drooped shut and his whole body flattened upon the floor at the same moment. Now everyone was worried and they wanted to save White Fang. They were making a lot of efforts and a veterinary surgeon was called in order to check White Fang. So when coming to the next slide, that is arrival of the veterinary surgeon. The veterinary surgeon worked on White Fang for about 1.5 hours. So that took a lot of time to treat White Fang. A long treatment went there of the White Fang, and it took about 1.5 hour. He had one broken hind leg and he had 3 broken ribs also. Means that was a very major problem was there with White Fang. He had a major treatment also, surgery. He major surgery went through he, and then after there was a large likelihood of internal injuries also. Now one chance in 1,000 is really optimistic. This was a statement given by the doctor. He says that it is optimistic. Meaning of optimistic is that hopeful and positive about the future. The doctor said that it was very very difficult. There was no hope for White Fang to get well. So it was very less chance. It was very less chance for in a 1,000 only. There was only one chance that he will get well soon. So he hasn't a chance in 10,000. So there was no hope for White Fang to get well, because he had one broken hind leg also, as well as he had 3 broken ribs. Now Judge Scott was very worried and he wanted just White Fang to get okay as soon as possible. He did not want to lose any chance of helping White Fang. So he ordered, he sent a message to San Francisco for Dr. Nicholas. And that Dr. Nicholas came here and he also treated White Fang. Now, long days went by. White Fang situation after treatment. So he was treated very well. There was no chance left by them for the White Fang to go well. Now, the surgeon tried his best to give White Fang a chance. Now, White Fang had the strength and energy of the wild in his blood. That is why he never he clung to life. He never weak. He never failed. He always tried to improve his health, and he always had the courage to get well, because he had the energy of the wild also. So he was unable to move due to plaster cast and bandages, but still he had hope and he tried his best to get well soon. Now at nights what happened, all the ghosts of the past arose in his mind and were with him. Once again he lived in the cave with Keech, or ran for his life from the howling dog pack. So dreams came into night. He kept on sleeping for whole days and he recovered very very slowly. And for it took him several weeks to recover. So he slept for long hours, and during those sleeping time, he dreamt a lot. Lot of dreams came to him. And during in his dreams, what did he see? He saw that he was with Beauty Smith as well. He was with Keech, his mother, and he was sometimes running for his life from the howling dog pack. So there were dreams also, and Beauty Fang and the dog fights he had fought. At such times he whimpered and snarled in his dream also. Snarled means growled fiercely with teeth bared. Now whimpered means made low feeble sounds expressing fear or pain. Because White Fang has suffered a lot and he had seen a lot of difficult times during his life. That is why all those things he reminded of while sleeping, and these situations came to him as his dreams. Now it took a lot of time for him to get well. Now the day came when the removal of the last bandage was there. Now this day was a gala day for White Fang, because it was the day when his last bandage was going to be removed. And after a lot of heroic efforts, he stood on his four legs, swaying back and forth. When the last bandage was removed, he made a lot of efforts and he tried to stand on his four legs, but still he was moving backwards and forth, and he was still trying. Judge Scott said that it just as I stated right along, no mere dog could have done what he did. He is a wolf. He is a fighter. He had the energy of wolf as well as the dog, and nobody else in place of him would have done. Only he has fought against the critical situations, and he had won over the hardships. Now a blessed wolf, corrected the judge's wife. Now he said that he's a blessed wolf and he'll have to learn to walk again, said the surgeon. So he might as well start right now. Now he was taken outside in order to walk for a while. He saw after a long time he went out of his house and everyone praised him there. The whole Sierra Vista was there to praise him when he went outside. Though White Fang was feeling very, very weak, but he felt like a king moving outside of the house. Now when he reached the lawn, he lay down and rested for a while. You can see in the picture also, everyone is loving. He is being cared by his masters also, and people are looking towards him. It was like a procession going on. Now back to life. After resting for a while in the lawn, when he was tired, White Fang used a little burst of strength once again, which was returning to his muscles. He, after resting for a while again, he gathered all his energy and he tried to stand. Now on the way, what happened? They reached the stables where the doorway collie was lying, and with a half a dozen plump puppies playing around her. Now White Fang was very fascinated, very excited to see all those puppies playing around collie. Now Fang felt very wonderful looking at them, and the master helped one puppy towards him, and he felt the warm little tongue on his jaw. Hence he also took out his tongue and licked the puppy's face there. Now this puppy, he was feeling the love and affection which was given by the puppy also. So White Fang in return, he also showed his love, and White Fang with his tongue, he also licked the puppy's face. He also loved the puppy in return. Now then his weakness once again returned, and he again lay down there and his head on one side, and he watched the puppy and he kept on watching those puppies very carefully. The other puppies also came crawling towards him, and he gravely permitted them to clamber and tumble over him. Now their antics continued, and he lay with half shut eyes. Now what is antics? Antics means foolish. His foolishness, these all foolish things, activities which were there by puppies. Puppies were jumping and crawling around him. So he allowed all those puppies to do whatever they wanted, and he lay with half shut eyes and he was drowsing in the sun. This was the life of White Fang, a fighter White Fang. And this shows that when you care for and love others, you become responsible for their well-being and safety. दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ व्हाइट फैंग. स्टूडेंट्स रीड द लेसन केयरफुली एंड लर्न द डिफिकल्ट स्पेलिंग्स ऑफ द वर्ड्स एज वेल एज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स विल बी देयर फॉर यू इन द You sent on your the school app. You just solve the question answers and read the lesson again and again for the revision. Okay, thank you.